Hello all, welcome to this course called Solve Aptitude Problems Easily. This is the fifth lesson of this course, and in this lesson let us learn how to do quick calculations like addition, subtraction and multiplication. Before starting, I want to ask you something. Do you know one human fact? The fact is that if given a chance, human beings tend to be as lazy as possible. And as the technology is advancing day by day, the laziness is also increasing. We have become so lazy that even for a simple calculation like 14 multiplied by 20, we depend on our smartphones for answers, isn't it? All through the previous lessons, I have warned you on how using calculators or other such devices will slow down your mental calculation power. That is, I repeat it once again. If you wish to crack your aptitude tests, then you must stop using calculators or other devices for solving mathematical problems as soon as possible. So, from this lesson, I would highly recommend you to start practicing to solve mathematical problems using mental power with the techniques that I am going to teach you in this lesson. Please be aware that calculators are not allowed during an aptitude test. Therefore, start your mental practice right now, right from this lesson. I also know that I have also told you in an earlier lesson that initially you can start with conventional approaches and slowly you can start adopting lateral thinking methods. But I want to tell you one more thing. How fast you can solve aptitude problems depends on how soon you can switch over to lateral thinking methodologies from conventional approaches. Therefore, as soon as possible, start adopting lateral thinking methodologies, my dear friends. In this lesson, I am going to teach you how to do mathematical calculations mentally without the need to use any calculators or by writing it down on a sheet of paper. But keep this in mind that to become good at mental calculations, you need tremendous practice. So start your practice right now. By the way, do you know what is the greatest advantage of dropping calculators for solving mathematical problems? If not, then listen to me very carefully. The advantage of dropping calculators for calculation is that your intelligent mind understands that the mental work is taking too much time and is leading to inaccurate answers. Therefore, it starts picking up shortcuts or smarter approaches that will help you to speed up the calculation and improve the accuracy. Having said that, I am sure you will now start using your mental power more than calculators, isn't it? Now, let's get into the meat of this lesson. That is, let's start learning different methods to do mathematical calculations mentally, starting from the next slide. Let's start with addition and subtraction. We can perform complicated addition and subtraction if we can break up those numbers into smaller and easier numbers. Human mind finds it always easier to do calculations when the numbers are brought into rounded figures, especially when it is in terms of tens, fifties, hundreds, 200s, 300s and thousands. So let us solve problems by trying to bring our numbers into the forms of tens or hundreds before solving it mentally. For example, 98 can be written as 100 minus 2. Similarly, 188 can be written as 200 minus 12. Similarly, 101 can be written as 100 plus 1 and so on. With this knowledge, let us solve further problems. If you have a calculation like 674 plus 92, then it may be easier for us to add 674 and 100 instead of 92 and then deduct 8 later. That is, this calculation can be mentally done as 674 plus 100, which will result in 774, and later we can do 774 minus 8 to get the right answer as 766. Therefore, by doing calculations in smaller steps, we will be faster while solving mathematical questions like this. Now, let me show you one more example. The calculation 772 plus 188 can be easily calculated as 772 plus 200, which is 972, and from this answer you can subtract 12, which will give us the actual result as 960. Similarly, 734 minus 94 can be calculated mentally as 734 minus 100, which gives us 634, and then to 634 we can add 6 to make it 640, which will be our actual answer. Now, did you notice how converting numbers in terms of hundreds help our mind to solve problems easily? Now, let me show you one more complicated calculation. 353 plus 655 plus 396. We can easily understand that this expression can be rewritten as 300 plus 53 plus 600 plus 55 plus 400 minus 96. It will be very easy to calculate mentally those numbers that are rounded off to hundreds first. That is 300 plus 600 plus 400. That is, we know we are adding these three numbers by reducing 53 from the first number, reducing 55 from the second number, and adding 4 extra to the last number. That is 300 plus 600 plus 400, which will result in 1300. But we know that this is not the final answer for our original question. That is, we need to add to the result 1300 the leftover values of 53, 55, and subtract the extra value of 4. This can be done as shown here. 1300 must be added with 53 plus 55 minus 4, and this expression can be further expanded and simplified by rounding off to 50s as shown here. That is, 1300 plus 50 plus 50 plus 3 plus 5 minus 4 will result in 1404. And this is the answer for 353 plus 655 plus 396. By bringing the calculations into the rounded figures, our mind finds it very easy to arrive at the right answer more quickly and easily. The same thing holds good for complicated subtractions as well. Now, as an assignment, can you solve the following question? 654 minus 345 minus 54 is equal to how much? I would highly recommend you not to use any kind of calculators, or don't scribble on a sheet of paper. Rather, try to use your mental power in solving this problem by yourself. Please don't move to the next slide until you solve the subtraction problem. If you're done, then let's move on. As said earlier, human mind finds it always easier to do calculations when numbers are brought into rounded figures, especially when it is in terms of tens, 15s, 50s, 100s, 200s, 300s and 1000s. Especially when solving multiplication problems, any number with 10, 100 or 1000 is very easy to be dealt with by our mind. This is because we need to just add one zero or two zeros to numbers when we multiply them by 10 or 100 respectively. Now, let us solve some interesting multiplication problems. While solving multiplication numbers, try to bring the numbers in the format of rounded numbers like tens or hundreds or thousands so that it becomes easy for calculation. Having said that, let's start. The first problem is 168 multiplied by 5. 168 multiplied by 5 can be easily calculated using our mental power. That is, 168 multiplied by 5 can be considered as 168 multiplied by 10 divided by 2, because 10 divided by 2 is nothing but 5, and therefore 5 can be easily replaced with 10 divided by 2. Going further, when we divide 168 divided by 2, it gives us the result as 84, which when multiplied by 10 gives us the final answer as 840. The problem is solved. Did you notice how easy it is to solve when we can bring in the values of tens and hundreds into the calculation? Such calculations are really a treat to our mind, my dear friends. Let me now show you one more multiplication problem. The problem is 28 multiplied by 25. 28 multiplied by 25 can be rewritten as 28 multiplied by 100 divided by 4, because we know the fact that 25 is nothing but 100 divided by 4. Therefore, 28 divided by 4 results in 7, which when multiplied by 100 gives us the final answer as 700. And hence, the right answer is 700, my dear friends. So what we are trying to do is that we are splitting the bigger numbers into smaller numbers using rounding off method before solving the actual problem. This is because our mind is very comfortable while solving smaller integers and rounded off numbers. Now, let us take another example of multiplying 68 with 75. In this case, we know 75 is 3/4 of 100. And therefore, we can easily replace 75 with 3 by 4 multiplied by 100. Therefore, 68 divided by 4 will result in 17, which when multiplied by 3 will result in 51, which when multiplied by 100 will result in the final answer of 5100. This is how we can simplify complicated looking calculations easily using our mental power. Now, let me show you one more interesting calculation. How to solve 56 multiplied by 1.25? This problem needs us to know that 1 divided by 8 is 0.125, and the moment we realize that 1 divided by 8 is 0.125, then it is clear that with our basic mathematical knowledge, 1.25 is nothing but 10 divided by 8, isn't it? Therefore, 56 multiplied by 1.25 can be easily replaced with 56 multiplied by 10 divided by 8. Next, By dividing 56 by 8, we get the result as 7, which when multiplied by 10, we'll get the final answer as 70. With this example, it is very evident that when bigger problems are divided into smaller pieces, it becomes easier for our mind to calculate easily and also very quickly. I will show you another example where we can convert multiplication into addition and subtraction before arriving at an answer. Check this. 240 multiplied by 2.2. This problem requires us to know that 1 divided by 5 is equal to 0.2. Therefore, 240 multiplied by 2.2 can be written as 240 multiplied by 2 plus 0.2 as a whole, which is nothing but 240 multiplied by 2 plus 240 multiplied by 0.2. Therefore, the resulting expression becomes 480 plus 240 multiplied by 0.2. We know 0.2 is nothing but 1 divided by 5. Therefore, 0.2 is nothing but 1 divided by 5. Therefore, after replacing 0.2 by 1 divided by 5, the expression becomes 480 plus 240 multiplied by 1 divided by 5. And by dividing 240 by 5, we get the answer as 48, which when added with 480, we'll get the final answer as 528. Did you notice how calculations become simple with simple modifications? And the best part is that these calculations can be quickly solved mentally without requiring us to use any kind of calculating tools. Now, let us move to learn some more techniques to solve multiplication problems. In the upcoming slide, I will show you how to solve multiplication problems using algebraic equations. If you are watching this on YouTube, then please do not forget to like, subscribe and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the new updates on aptitude and problem solving. Having said that, meet you in the next lesson. Until then, take care. Bye-bye. Love you all so much.